Let me ask you this. What if I told you that there was a special chip in your computer that has absolute control over your entire system, is remotely accessible, has secret proprietary code that you can't look at, and there's no way to disable it? Well, it's true, and it's actually pretty scary. Let me introduce you to two things you've probably never heard of before. Intel Management Engine, or Intel ME, and AMD Platform Security Processor. Like I just said, these are essentially backdoors into almost every computer made in the past 10 years or so. Intel and AMD swear up and down that they're only used for legitimate purposes, though we have no choice but to take their word for it. First, let's talk about what these actually are, starting with Intel Management Engine. It's basically an isolated, standalone coprocessor that is physically embedded into every Intel chipset. To put it simply, it's like a mini computer within your computer. But the scary thing about it is that no one knows exactly what it does because it's got proprietary code, and Intel has not released that source code. Now, obviously, it has legitimate features that Intel has no problem talking about, but you can't help but wonder if there's a little bit more to it. Here's a list of things that this hardware can do. It has access to all of your computer's RAM, completely bypassing the main CPU. It has access to everything attached to your computer, every peripheral. It can access your network interface to send and receive traffic, also bypassing the firewall in your operating system, or even if your operating system isn't running at all. And to top it all off, it can remotely power on and off your computer. So it's also no surprise that it can do all these things even if your computer is turned off. Of course, if the rest of the computer is turned off, there isn't much it could do anyway since your hard drive and memory aren't powered, but still. By now you might be thinking, what the hell? Why does this even exist? Why does this chip have access to everything? Why can't I disable it? Well, its main purpose is to allow you or a company system administrator to remotely monitor, maintain, update, or repair your computer. So for example, this is especially useful in companies where they might manage thousands and thousands of computers. It doesn't make sense to go around to every single computer in person to install updates. You really need to be able to do it remotely in bulk without requiring employees to do anything themselves. So you might also think, okay, that actually makes sense. I could see how it might be helpful for some people, but I don't need any of that. This is my own personal computer, so how do I disable it? Well, I've got bad news for you. You can't. And you can't buy an Intel processor without one. As I mentioned before, you can't even escape it by going with an AMD processor. You see, they have their own version of this Platform Security Processor, or PSP, and it's a different implementation, but for the purposes of this video, they're close enough. It has the same super privileges as Intel ME. It can basically control everything on your computer, and we have no idea what the actual code is. The next thing you guys would probably say is, okay, so all of my computers have a secret backdoor, great. But at least my cell phone doesn't use AMD or Intel, so surely I'm safe. Wrong. Have you ever heard of a baseband processor? Probably not. Every cell phone has one, and its purpose is to convert between digital signals and radio signals for the phone's antenna. So you need one of these for your phone to even work. And yes, this one also has low-level access to all sorts of data on your phone. But the most important thing to note about this is just like Intel ME and AMD PSP, baseband processors are all proprietary. So no matter what manufacturer makes the phone, they all have their own version of this black box processor that can't be accessed but can control your device. So most of you would probably say, all right, that's really creepy that every computer I own has some sort of backdoor that I can't disable, but I really don't think Intel and AMD are actually using this to spy. But that's not the main issue here. I mean, yes, I agree that it's very unlikely that Intel and AMD are actually using this to spy on people. Almost definitely not. They'd have little to gain and everything to lose if it was ever found out. But it's not Intel and AMD that we need to worry about. You see, the real problem is the possibility that these special chips could be cracked by some hacker group or more likely some government. I mean, these chips obviously are protected with some hardcore encryption, but that doesn't mean someone couldn't discover some very clever exploits for it. And if that happened, they would potentially be able to take control of literally any computer they wanted remotely. And no one would ever know because they can't see into the chip in the first place, so they wouldn't know it was exploited anyway. And on top of that, because it bypasses the main processor altogether, there'd be no way to stop it, and you wouldn't even know it's doing anything. And I don't even think you'd be able to defend against attack like this either. If you think about it, this thing has dedicated access to your network interface. So if an attacker were to send you a malicious payload to your computer, even if it were blocked by your software firewall and your operating system, it might still go directly to the black box chip and infect it because it would still read everything. By the way, you just know that the government is trying to crack this technology. I mean, they'd be stupid not to. It's like the holy grail of all hacks. So the sheer magnitude of this thing existing, that risk is outweighed by whatever tiny probability that they'll exploit it in a way that would be completely disastrous. To give you an idea, I want you to imagine this. We'll do something a little bit fun. You have this uncrackable safe. Like, the lock on this thing is truly perfect, it can't be picked, there's an infinite number of combinations, and also the walls of the case are made of an imaginary metal that's impenetrable by any drill or tool known to man. But now what happens is you put everything you own into that safe. And then you take that safe and put it outside on your front doorstep so anybody passing by can walk up to it and look at this safe. And not only that, everyone in the entire world also has this exact same safe. How much effort do you think someone like the government might dedicate to finding a way into that safe? How long do you think it would take before they find the tiniest, most obscure, unthinkable weakness that lets them into it? Well, surely, it would take a long time and a lot of work probably, but it would eventually happen. Maybe they find out that if they tilt the safe at exactly 0.25 radians and heat it up to 100 degrees Fahrenheit and apply a magnetic field of 100 Tesla, that the door just falls off. I mean, what are the odds that anyone would figure that out? But really, stuff like this, it's not a matter of if, but when. And more importantly, once they find an exploit, it doesn't matter how secure the lock or the walls of the safe are, they're still getting in. Some of you may be familiar with a concept called security through obscurity, where the basic idea is that if you hide something well enough, or keep its design a complete secret, that no one can exploit it because they don't know anything about it. And it's not always a bad idea, actually. Kind of like how you might hide your money in the pages of a book on your shelf instead of a safe in your closet. In that case, you're betting that the chance of someone finding it in that bookshelf is less than the chance that they'd be able to open whatever safe you put it in. In computer security, there are some advantages and disadvantages you might argue with security through obscurity as opposed to open source. The argument for open source is that because everyone can look at the code, good guys can then find the exploits and report them to be fixed before the bad guys can use them. Whereas if the code is proprietary, bad guys might be the only ones who find the exploits, and obviously they're never going to report them. On the other hand, the argument for security through obscurity is that if the code is open sourced, exploits are more likely to be found in the first place, and there's no guarantee that the good guys will be the ones that find them. And also, bad guys might be more willing to spend time searching for these exploits since they would get way more out of finding them. I think both arguments can be valid depending on the situation, but the main thing to know is that no matter what you do, you can never be 100% truly secure no matter how hard you try. For example, you might have the strongest password ever, but if someone puts a gun to your head, you're gonna give it up. Going back to the main topic of this video, that means that it doesn't matter how supposedly secure these chips are, just their existence poses a massive risk. But before you get too worried, there is a shred of hope. In a Reddit thread, AMD was asked about making their PSP processor open source, and they responded that executive-level attention would be given to looking into the possibility of releasing that source code for the platform security processor. To be clear, they didn't say they would do it, they didn't even say they might do it, but they did say that this has CEO-level attention and AMD is investigating the steps and resources necessary to support this. So you're saying there's a chance? Well, we'll have to see. If they did release the source code, it would not only allow the code to be audited for exploits, but possibly allow it to be disabled altogether if you want it, which honestly, I don't know why there isn't the option to do that already. So now that we've seen the light of just how exposed we could be, no matter how small the possibility, what can we do about it? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Seriously. It doesn't matter what operating system you use, there's no special command to turn it off, and if you physically go in and break the chip somehow, your computer will refuse to boot. Really, the only thing you can do is follow the usual advice for securing your computer in every other way and hope for the best. So yeah, I hate to stop it there, but that's really it. Hopefully this video didn't freak you out too much. So be sure to let me know what you think. And if you want to keep watching, you can click on these videos right here. I really recommend them. And also, if you want to subscribe, I make new videos 3 times a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, so it should be worth it. So as usual, thanks for watching, guys. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.